Welcome back to another video. My name's Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me. And I'm going to show you how to do something really, really cool in this video. And that is how to add a pop-up box that can have anything you want in it on your Beaver Builder website. And you don't have to have the Beaver Builder theme for this. You just need to have the Beaver Builder plugin and an add-on package that I'm going to show you that adds this really awesome functionality. You could do some really amazing things with pop-ups. And I had a client recently where they asked if I would put a video on a page I designed for them. And I know when I looked at it, it just really wouldn't fit. And I thought, this should really be maybe a button where they click on it and a video pops up. And so I was looking at my favorite add-on package. Now, part of the reason it's my favorite add-on package is because it's the only one I own. I bought it with my own money. I'm not some rich guy buying all these add-on packages. So I'm very conservative when I end up buying something. I want to buy stuff that I'm going to use, and I'm usually not going to buy something else that does the same thing. I'm going to stick with what I have, unless the other thing does a better job at it. So I went to the Ultimate Add-ons website for Beaver Builder, and I saw when I clicked on modules, they have this module right here, Modal Pop-Up. I don't know why they call it the Modal. I know that's probably a technical term, but most people don't know what the heck that is. So it says Pop-Up, and it's coming soon. So I contacted them and asked them if I can have an advanced copy of the plugin that has this add-on already in it so that I could use it for this client. And they were very generous, and I asked if I can make this video, and they said yes as well. So I'm going to go over this new module that they're adding, and there's a lot of creative uses for it, and so I'm going to try to cover some of them as best as I can in this video. But they do have some demos up, and they have these 8 demos of it. So here is a demo where when you click on it, just some content comes out, and everything is customizable. I'm going to show you all the options in it. Here's one for a photo. You notice how you can change the color of the background there. And you can also choose if you want a border there. You don't have to. Here's a video embed. So when you click on it, it just pops up a video. And if you notice that there's different animation options. Okay, so here's where you can have a saved row. So you can create a row in Beaver Builder, and you can select that to be the contents of your pop-up. That is some powerful stuff right there. Here's for saved modules. And also saved page templates. And I was actually thinking this would be really good for anyone that wants to have a portfolio but not have it be the take up so much space on their website. So if you have a client and you've designed some pages in Beaver Builder, well, you could actually export those pages, import them on your site, and add them to these pop-ups to really showcase some of the work that you do. Anyways, this is your full saved page template. Here's a YouTube video. You might see someone familiar. And you can even get rid of this border, by the way. So if you don't want that border, you can get rid of it. You can change the background color here, the color, the opacity. Everything is controllable, including this is controllable too. You can have that be whatever you want. And here's a Vimeo video. So these are the 8 demos. Let's jump into the back end of WordPress and take a look at the settings on my site. So here I am, I'm logged in. Now I'm gonna give you a little bit of a tease here. So if I go to settings and then page builder, and this is where you typically find your Beaver Builder settings, you can see right here something pretty interesting, but I am not gonna click on that. That's something for a different video. I just asked if I could get an advanced copy for the pop-up and if I can make a video, but I'll go into what this is in a different video. So you're gonna wanna click on modules if this is your first time installing it. And when you scroll down, this is where you can actually enable or disable modules. And when you scroll down, here's all the ultimate add-on modules right here. And I have them all checked right now, but you can choose which ones you want. This photo gallery is also a new one. This ribbon is new. They have a couple new ones in here, but I'm just going to talk about these pop-ups because they're so cool. So I'm going to go into pages, and I'm just going to jump into my home page and click on Page Builder so I can get into the Beaver Builder interface. And here it is. So I'm just going to search for it, pop-up. Let's see. Yep, there it is, modal pop-up. So the way it works is you can drag and drop this wherever you want it. So say I wanted a pop-up button underneath here. I will drag and drop that there, and up pops my settings panel right here. So I'm going to try to go over all of these. You know, some of these pop-ups, you don't even need to trigger with a button. You can actually have a trigger with some action, maybe time on the page, or that whole exit intent thing where when someone's scrolling off the page, or maybe right when someone gets to the website. So there's lots of different triggers for these pop-ups, which is actually pretty darn cool. And the reason why I think the way that Ultimate Add-ons is implementing it is so awesome is they actually also have pre-built a lot of this technology. They have a plugin called Convert Plug that is a plugin that allows you to capture opt-ins and things of that nature on your website. So anyways, now you can do anything with these pop-ups. You can use them for lead generation, for relaying information, for notices. There's so many cool things you could do with it. It's pretty powerful. So right here, you can have a real basic pop-up where you just have text. You can have a title and some text right here. But right here is the option where you can actually choose different types of content. So when I expand this right here, I can choose a photo, my video embed code, which is pretty awesome. So if you are using video that's not on Vimeo, not on YouTube, you can embed it here as well, or maybe even an audio embed code. Here's where you can choose your saved rows, modules, templates, YouTube, or Vimeo. So I know I have some saved page templates, so I can click on that. And I've got a couple here. Maybe I can just choose this Adam's template right there. You can see the width is defined in the pop-up options right here. So you see where it says maximum width. That's why it looks funny, because it's taking this page and it's scrunching it all in. But I'm sure if I expanded this out to maybe like 900 or something like that, it would go ahead and kind of look normal. So yeah, there it is. It's looking better already. And I can get rid of this content padding right here. I think I probably wouldn't really use the padding. I would like to just set it as zero. And there it is. So here is a full page. I think I'm going to implement this on my website for showing full page designs, especially for templates that might be for sale. Anyways, when you scroll down here, you have the effect when it appears. You could do something real basic, but there's all these really nice effects that you can choose. And they're not like hokey dorky type of effects. I mean, they're really cool effects that can get your attention. So if you're using where you're showing some of the padding on the side, you can right here choose the background color for that. And here's where we could choose the overlay color. So right now I have it as this dark color. So let's see if I make it like a annoying green or something like that. And then I can choose my opacity right here. So if I wanted it to, you know, have very little opacity, I can do that. And so you have those options there. So let's look at this tab where it says appear on. And this is where we're going to have all these options. So we can create a button. It could just be text. It could be an image that someone clicks on, an icon. We can also tie this into a custom class, which is pretty cool. And automatic, that's where we're going to choose some parameters where it's not someone clicking something in order for it to pop up. Let me show those real quick. So if I click on automatic, right here is before user leaves, and this is like an exit intent after a few seconds, and you can specify those seconds. So if I click on yes, if I wanted it to appear the minute someone got on the page, I can have this set to zero, or I can have there be some kind of a delay. So let me set that to no. Let's see if there's any additional options with this. Nope, there isn't. Okay. All right, and so this is actually really thoughtful of them. You can enable cookies, and this is going to allow you to control if someone comes back to the site, are they going to see this again? So let's just see what options are there. I'm going to choose yes. And right here, we can choose a range. So if I set this to 2, when someone comes to my website and sees this pop-up, it won't appear again for 2 days. Or if they go into another web browser, it'll probably appear, or if they clear their cookies but you're going to have some pretty good control over it. Now, you also have options for this close button. So if you see right there, it's an X, and we can choose whatever we want. So if I click on replace, you have the choice of all of these different options. So you're definitely going to want a form of an X, because if you don't, someone might not know that they need to click on it. Unfortunately, that does happen, but you can choose whatever you wanted, like maybe throw in a house, and then you could choose the size here, the color of it, whatever you want. And so now it's a little home. For some people, you might want to make it larger, so I just changed that to 60, which should probably close to double the size, but that wouldn't make sense. You're going to want an X. But you can also change the position of where you want it. There it is. So right now it's actually the top right. I can put it maybe on the top right of the actual pop-up like that, and that should move it to be right next to the pop-up itself. Okay, so now you can actually choose also what action someone would do to make this go away. So it could be just clicking on that X or whatever you put there, but you can also have it be if someone hits the escape key or clicks on the overlay. I think you should enable this overlay click option, because I do that sometimes. I just want to click there and have it go away. And then you have your standard options here of topography and your advanced options. So anyways, and then you can just go ahead and save it. What did I do? I think I might have set this to trigger after a few seconds, right? So let's see if I click on done and then publish. Hopefully I didn't do the X intent. Let's see. So it's going to take me to the page. I actually just went back and made it work as the exit intent. And that just means when you take your mouse and you move it out of this browser window, it should trigger it like that. And there it is. It just triggered it. And you can scroll down. So I had this full page template showing. But you can see how really cool this would be to show. You can do just all kinds of things. You can have page-specific pop-ups. You can have light boxes for your videos. You can capture leads. You can do amazing things. You can demo your portfolio. You can do all kinds of cool stuff. So that is it to making pop-ups for your Beaver Builder-based website using the Ultimate Add-ons plugin. The Ultimate Add-ons plugin isn't that expensive. I think it's like $60 or $70 right now. And you get all these modules, rows, and pretty soon you're going to have full page templates for it. And I love it, and I use it on my personal website. I use a lot of the different modules. Now, I do have links to Beaver Builder and Ultimate Add-ons down below. Now, when you click on those links and it goes over to their website, those are affiliate links. And what that means is if you were to purchase it, they give me a small commission. It's not a huge commission. It's really a small commission. And so if you did want to purchase either of those, I'd appreciate it if you did it through my links. However, that is not why I talk about these products. I talk about them because I own them, bought them with my own money, and I currently use them and love them and fully believe in them. Now, if you did buy Ultimate Add-ons or Beaver Builder through one of my links, I have a course that I'd like to give to you for free. All you'd have to do is forward your receipt over to me, and I'll verify that you purchased it through my link. The name of the course is Beaver Builder Essentials, and what that's going to do is it's going to take the person that's new to Beaver Builder and maybe even building a website, and it's going to take you through the whole process of having and building an entire website using Beaver Builder, and I'd like to give that to you. Hey, before you go, I have something for you, and before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm going to give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.